Good afternoon, and welcome to Glam's 52nd Annual Memorial Concert as we remember Glam members Alma Birch, Opal Carter, and Alva Harper. We will also remember soprano Carmen Balthrop, conductor Michael Morgan, and rap artist Nipsey Hussle. Every year, we pause to remember loved ones, colleagues, and friends. We certainly hope that you'll enjoy today's program as we celebrate lives remembered but not forgotten.
How do you keep the music playing? How do you make it last? How do you keep a song from fading too fast? How do you lose yourself to someone and never lose your way? How do you not run out of new things to say? And if we know we're always changing, how can it be the same? And tell me how year after year you're sure your heart will fall apart each time you hear her name. I know the way I feel for you, it's now or never. The more I love, the more that I'm afraid that in your eyes I may not see forever. Forever. If we can be the best of lovers, yet be the best of friends, if we can try with every day to make it better as it grows, with any luck that I suppose the music I know the way I feel for you, it's now or never. The more I love, the more that I'm afraid that in your eyes I may not see forever. If we can be the best of lovers, yet be the best of friends, if we can try with every day to make it better as it grows, with any luck that I suppose the music never ends. Alma Betty Horn Burch was born on May 6, 1934, in West Palm Beach, Florida, to William Henry Horn and Laura Wyatt Horn. Alma was the youngest and last living of 11 children. She attended school in the West Palm Beach area. She married Elzia Lee Burch Jr. of West Palm Beach, Florida. They were married for over 60 years. From this union came three children, Elzia Burch III, Leslie Denise Burch McCauley, and Nancy Regina Burch, Elziola Wedkume, deceased. Alma was an excellent pianist who also had a celestial voice. She and Elzia moved to Los Angeles in the late 1950s. Upon arrival, she played piano and sang in many churches in the Los Angeles area. They settled in Compton, California in the 1960s. She worked for the city of Los Angeles for 20 years and attended California State University, Dominguez Hills, where she received her Bachelor of Arts degree in criminal justice. She loved her church, Grand African Methodist Episcopal Church of Los Angeles, of which she was a member for many years. She was a member of the Willie B. Webster Women's Missionary Society in the Dio Giovante unit. For her 25 years of mission service, Mrs. Burch was inducted into the Cleo B. Love Hall of Recognition at the 92nd session of the Southern California Conference of the African Methodist Episcopal Church. She served for many years as a member of the adult choir of her church, under the directorship of Dr. Don Lee White, and was happy to welcome her good friend, Mr. Byron J. Smith, as he took over the helm, and she was a proud member of the alto section. Ms. Burch was also the director and musician for the Memorial Choir, which provided music at funerals and memorial services. Ms. Burch rose up early in the morning and found the Grand AME Prayer Ministry as members of the church would gather in prayer. She was also a member of the Georgia Laster Association of Musicians Incorporated, an affiliate branch of the National Association of Negro Musicians Incorporated, where she was a life member. On August 30th, 2021, Alma Betty went home to be with the Lord. She leaves to cherish her memories, her children, Elvia Burch III, and his wife, Kathy, daughter, Leslie Denise McCauley, and her husband, Rodney, and eight grandchildren and three great-grandchildren and a host of relatives and friends. Mama Burch's words, "I love you all. I want to go home. Everything will be all right. Turn off the lights. Night, night." She also wrote, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths." Proverbs 3, 5, and 6.
Eleanor also Brooks remembers Juliet also Brooks, daughter, Barbara Dumas, friend. Patty Anderson remembers Freddie L. Anderson, PhD, spouse. Clarence and Letha Childs, parents. Blossom Childs, sister-in-law. Gertrude Bradley remembers Clara G. Thompson, mother. Ray C. Bradley, father. Eugene C. Bradley, brother. Apostle Frederick Casey Price, pastor and teacher. Dr. Charles Queen, Hebrew teacher. Yvonne Bragg remembers Columbus and Mary Mitchell, parents. Columbus Mitchell Jr., brother. Mercer Mitchell, brother. Jerry Mitchell, brother. Arthur and Mary Bragg, in-laws. Annie Mae Butler remembers Dr. Peter Butler Jr., husband. Myra Ada B. Cuff, daughter. Rosemarie Cook Glover remembers Dr. Jacqueline Broussard, friend. Dr. J. Harrison Wilson, friend. Opal Mitchell Carter, friend. Danellen Joseph, friend. Opal Borders, friend. Patsy Chester, friend. Dr. Paul Sweetnam, friend. Wardell Howard, friend. Dorothy J. Hayes, friend. Catherine L. Belser, mother. Faye Coward remembers Dorothy Jackson Hayes, friend. Estella Creighton remembers Nellie L. Creighton, mother. Abraham Creighton, uncle. Oliver Creighton, uncle. Alistine Creighton, aunt. Samuel L. Casey, cousin. Francine Davis remembers Faye Jackson, friend, Holman Choir. Major Wilburn, friend, Holman Choir. Melanie Hayes, friend.
Opal Mitchell Coates Carter. A native of Charleston, West Virginia, Opal Carter was born December 5, 1924. After graduating from Garnet High School, Opal enrolled at West Virginia State College, now University, with a major in education and a minor in music. Gifted with a beautiful voice, Opal was a soloist in the college choir and an honored member of the girls' octet. After graduating in 1947, Opal began teaching in elementary school and became active in establishing the West Virginia State College National Alumni Association. Tragically, Opal's beloved first husband was fatally injured in a horrific fire as he attempted to rescue his fellow firemen. Opal remained in Charleston and continued to teach and stay vitally involved at her beloved alma mater. In 1955, her life changed dramatically when she married her second husband, Marcus Carter, and with him made her home in Los Angeles, California. In 1956, Opal began her teaching career with the Enterprise City School District, later Compton Unified School District. Recognized as an outstanding educator, Opal was appointed to a number of administrative positions and received an Outstanding Director's Award from the Association of California School Administrators Association, one of many honors and awards. She retired from her last position in the Compton Unified School District as Associate Director of Student Assessment, Research, and Evaluation in 1996. Opal's lifelong desire to be of service to the community found her participating in numerous organizations. She continued her work with the NAACP, a lifelong member, and extended her personal interest to include memberships in Special People into Community Endeavors, SPICE, the Georgia Laster Association of Musicians, a chapter of the National Association of Negro Musicians, the Southeast Symphony Association Board of Directors, the Southeast Symphony Association Conservatory of Music, and the Compton Conservatory of Music. In addition, her service to others included active memberships in the Theta Omega chapter of Alpha Kappa Alpha International Sorority Incorporated and Beta Phi chapter of Phi Delta Kappa National Sorority Incorporated, where she rose to become Far Western Region Director. Honored extensively and working tirelessly, Opal Mitchell Coates Carter was a beacon of light in the legacy of courage, achievement, and excellence. Often referring to herself as precious jewel, that she was.
Thank you. Gloria Dean remembers Callie Mae Hood, mother, Walter Hood, Jr., brother, Tiffany Lynette Lee, niece, Dolly Mae Dean, mother-in-law, Warren Dean, Sr., father-in-law, Dorothy Leggett, sister-in-law, Bobby Leggett, brother-in-law, George Silva, friend, Daniel Payne, cousin, Reverend Anita Bowden, friend. Henrietta Fortson remembers Lucy R. Fortson, mother, Henry L. Fortson, father, Charles Henry Fortson, M.D., brother, Frederick D. Fortson, brother, John H. Fortson, brother, Burnett L. Fortson, brother, William Fortson, cousin, Regina Davis, friend, Robert Ball, friend, Dorothy Jackson Hayes, friend, Moses Cole, friend, Edward Lindsay, friend, Alva Harper, friend, Dr. J. Harrison Wilson, friend, Fanny Benjamin, friend, Dr. Don Lee White, friend, Javon Fortson, niece, Carol R. Simmons, niece, Vernell Ford, voice teacher. Raquel Fuller Green remembers Alva Harper, friend. Joel and Jean Graham remembers Donna B. Graham, grandmother, Emma R. Graham, mother, Michelle Graham, daughter, Charles Graham, uncle, Wilbur Graham, uncle, Genova Wash, aunt, Millie Ann Petty, mother, Walter Petty, father, Joyce Moore, sister, Pruitt Petty, brother, Ernest Bright, brother-in-law.
Alva Pearl Patton Harper was born on October 17, 1932, in Danville, Kentucky. She graduated first in her class from Bate High School in May 1950. Her talent for singing was noticed very early at Bate High School, and she sang in the Glee Club throughout her high school years. After graduation, she auditioned at the University of Louisville School of Music at Garden Court, Louisville. She was awarded one of two voice scholarships. She studied opera and classical music. Although Alva had a God-given natural talent, it was her voice teacher who sadly discouraged her not to pursue music. In 1954, she moved to Chicago and married Robert Harper. They divorced several years later. Alva retired from the Los Angeles Unified School District in June 1990 after 30 years. She was a school administrative assistant at Jordan High School, Crenshaw High School, and Westside Alternative School, where she retired. While at Jordan High School, she sang the role of Mother in Amahl and the Night Visitors, a Christmas opera by Giancarlo Menotti. Singing this role was a major highlight in Alva's life. After retiring, she volunteered with the Cultural Affairs Committee at Village Green, where she was a member for 19 years before retiring from the committee. And she also volunteered for the Douglas Michael Fuller Foundation for Neuroblastoma, a cancer that affects children, as CFO to the end of her life. Raquel Fuller Green is the founder of this organization. Please listen to a tribute to Alva from Raquel Rocky, as she is known, Fuller Green.
To my dear friend Alva, I miss your smile and our talks every day about good food, recipes, and just about anything you can think of. Going back to our Crenshaw High School days, we always ate nutrition and lunch in the cafeteria together. I thank you for being the Chief Financial Officer of the Douglas Michael Fuller Foundation for Neuroblastoma, a cancer that only affects children. I love you and thanks for being my friend. Love, Rocky.
As a member of the Georgia Laster Association of Negro Musicians Incorporated, NAM, Alva served as chair of the Sunshine Committee for many years. She was a member of the Trinity Baptist Church until the end of her life. In April 1995, she was diagnosed with kidney disease, and thanks to the goodness of our Almighty God, in September 1998, she received a kidney transplant jointly with Kaiser Permanente and UCLA. Alva passed away peacefully in her home on April 8th, 2021. She was 89 years old. Alva was predeceased by her sister Rowena Bush, who unfortunately passed in April 2020. She is survived by her brother, Liam Patton Jr. of Chicago, her nephew, Tyrone Hooks, niece, Rowalanda Hooks, a host of cousins and their children, plus relatives in Chicago, Lisa Thompson and Henry Thompson Jr. Thank you, Alva, for sharing your life with us. We will truly miss you and will keep memories of your lovely spirit in our hearts.
It's flowing from the fountain. flowing from the fountain. Be baptized, oh, this is the healing water. Water, water, oh, this is the healing water. Be baptized.
Betty A. Harbison remembers Moulton A. Harbison, Jr., father, Mrs. Betty N. Harbison, mother. Mrs. Lucy M. Norwood Scott, grandmother. Mrs. Polly C. Foster Norwood, great-grandmother. Mrs. Dorothy Jackson Hayes, mentor. Dr. Jean Uger, friend. Mrs. Marion Flowers, friend. Shirley Howard remembers husband Wardell Howard. Ingrid Kelly remembers Ernest Kelly, father. Burnett Fortson, uncle. Gwendolyn Kelly Daniels remembers Henry Fortson, father. Lucy R. Fortson, mother. Dr. Charles H. Fortson, sibling. John L. Fortson, sibling. Burnett Fortson, sibling. Merle and Albert Luck remember Alva Harper, friend. Dorothy Jackson Hayes, friend. Mildred Matthews, friend. Valencia Mitchell remembers Roy Harris, father. Emily May Harris, mother. Joseph David Mitchell II, father-in-law. Mary Louise Mitchell, mother-in-law. John Wesley Mitchell, brother-in-law. Virginia Ward, family-in-law. Michael Harrison, friend. Paul Wayman, friend. Frederick Ficus, violin instructor. Nathan Rubin, violin instructor. Betty Randall remembers Opal Carter, mentor and friend. Hazel Story remembers Mr. Warren Story, husband. Mr. and Mrs. Lavelle Conley, parents. Barbara Terrell remembers Eileen Triggs, mother. Wilbon Triggs Jr., brother. Dr. Rachel Eubanks, friend. James West II remembers James Edward West I, father. Hattie Jane Foote, grandmother. Johnny West remembers Hattie Jane Foote, mother. Rita and Ricky West remember Nina Trotter, Rita's mother. Dora Jackson, Rita's grandmother. Christopher Perry, son. Doris McNichols, Ricky's mother. Sadie Boyd, Ricky's grandmother.
A reading from the Book of Proverbs, from the section which is often known as the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the many, to be dead, but they are at peace. God took them to himself, and grace and mercy are with his beloved, and his care is with his elect. It is a tradition with the Georgia Laster Association of Musicians to remember and honor members who have passed in the last year, and also to recognize friends, family, associates, and famous musicians of the world. During the past few years, the pandemic and the illnesses that it caused have taken their toll on our membership, and this year's celebration is in honor of them. We acknowledge them all and miss them more than words can say. Grief is known to all of us. It comes over us in waves of remembrance. We keep our loved ones in our memories and in our hearts. They would not want us to be sad when we think of them. They would love for us to have joyful memories of them, all the fun times we shared, and the funny things that made us laugh and made us love them. So let us all remember the wonderful legacy that they and we have given to the world, the contributions and the many things that no one else could have accomplished, and what they gave to the world in the name of music and life. How precious have their lives been to all of us. We miss them, but they are and will always stay in our hearts and in our memories.
Our Georgia Laster Association of Musicians Incorporated proudly celebrates the legacy of Carmen Balthrop, internationally renowned diva. Raised in Washington, D.C., she was inspired to pursue the art of singing after hearing the voice of Leontine Price over her father's radio when she was 8 years old. She studied vocal performance at the University of Maryland, receiving her Bachelor of Music degree in 1971. She went on to Catholic University in Washington, receiving the Master of Music degree in 1972 with an opera concentration. Miss Balthrop then won the Metropolitan Opera National Auditions and made her Met debut in 1977. In addition to performing the works of Mozart, Verdi, Puccini, and Gershwin, she became recognized for her performance in a Scott Joplin opera. Yes, she was Tremonisha, performing the role with the Houston Opera on Broadway and on PBS. Her career took her to many international opera houses, including the San Francisco Opera, Washington National Opera, the Deutsche Oper of Berlin, and Theater Phoenice. In 1985, Miss Balthrop returned to the University of Maryland, her alma mater, where she taught at the School of Music for 36 years. She became the music school's associate director for academic affairs and undergraduate studies, as well as the coordinator of the voice and opera division. Her students remember her as a teacher who had both a beautiful voice and a beautiful soul. She was an active arts advocate, remembered for singing an aria in the United States Senate and testifying before a congressional subcommittee to advocate for National Endowment for the Arts funding. Carmen Balthrop passed away on September 5, 2021. We proudly celebrate this dynamic diva.
Of Musicians Incorporated proudly celebrates the legacy of Motown's soul-singing supreme, Mary Wilson. Born in Greenville, Mississippi, she was sent to Detroit at age 3 to be raised by her aunt and uncle, where she lived in the Brewster Douglas housing project. She became a member of the Primettes with Florence Ballard, Diana Ross, and Betty McLaurin. The group changed some of its members and its name becoming the Supremes, and in 1961 signed with Motown Records. Mary Wilson was a founding member of the Supremes. They had their first number one hit in 1964, Where Did Our Love Go? And followed with a series of hits, Baby, I Need Your Lovin', Baby Love, Stop in the Name of Love, and Come See About Me. In the next years, they recorded Back in My Arms Again, I Hear a Symphony, Love is Like an Itching in My Heart, and My World is Empty Without You. She performed all over the world with the group, on television and headlining at clubs like the Copacabana, and generally opening up doors for other Motown, R&B, and soul music performers. Miss Wilson died suddenly in 2021 at the age of 76. We proudly celebrate this internationally recognized singing supreme.
Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present the Up Close with Mary Wilson show.
Was it in Tahiti? Were we on the Nile? Long, long ago, say an hour or so, I recall that I saw your smile. I remember you. You're the one who made my dreams come true. A few kisses ago, who said, I love you too. I do. Didn't you know? I remember too a distant bell and stars that fell like rain out of the blue. When my life is through and the angels ask me to recall the thrill of them all, then I shall tell them I remember you. No complaints, no regrets. I still believe in chasing dreams and placing bets. But I have learned that all you give is all you get. So give it all you got. I've had my share. I drank my fill. And even though I'm satisfied, I'm hungry still to see what's down another road beyond the hill and do it all again. This song is perhaps the summation of what I'm trying to say, what I tried to say this evening in music. It's a song that I heard back in the 60s, sung by Joni Mitchell. It was a folk song then, and I loved it then, but I never ever thought or considered singing it. However, now that I'm 62 and a half or three quarters, whatever I am, I understand it. I understand it now.
I looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow wins. Love's illusions that I recall. I really don't know love. I really don't know love at all. May all your storms be weathered, and all that's good get better.
Georgia Laster Association of Musicians Incorporated proudly celebrates the legacy of Michael Morgan. Born in Washington, D.C., he began studying piano at the age of 8. By the age of 12, he had become a conductor, serving as the conductor of the D.C. Youth Orchestra while he was in high school. He then was able to study at top musical institutions in the country, Oberlin Conservatory of Music and the Berkshire Music Center. He also studied with internationally known conductors and composers, including Gunther Schuller and Seiji Ozawa. His illustrious professional career includes serving as assistant conductor of the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. He was then artistic director of the Oakland Youth Orchestra and music director and conductor of the Oakland Symphony from 1991 until his death in 2021 at the age of 63. It is noted that he built that orchestra into a model of community involvement while commissioning numerous new works for the ensemble to perform. Over the years, he guest conducted many of America's orchestras, including the New York Philharmonic, the San Francisco Symphony, and the Los Angeles Philharmonic. He also led the orchestras of the Vienna State Opera, the New York City Opera, the St. Louis Opera Theater, and the Washington National Opera. He was a conductor of the nationally celebrated Black Music Repertory Ensemble, and throughout his career, he was an advocate for the valuable contributions of African American composers and performers. We celebrate this maestro's skill, creativity, and artistic vision. His baton made a lasting impact.
Our Georgia Laster Association of Musicians Incorporated proudly celebrates the legacy of the Grammy-nominated rapper Nipsey Hussle. And we also acknowledge his work as an entrepreneur and a community activist. Within the music industry, he was an established presence who had collaborated with a variety of artists, including Drake and Diddy. Born Ermias Joseph Ashedem in 1985, Hussle was a force in the Southern California rap scene. He released his first mixtape, Slawson Boy, Volume 1, in 2005, when he was 20 years old, and he was dedicated to living up to the name he chose for himself, Hussle. His sound was defined by a reverence to the West Coast gangster rap of the 1990s, making an impression among the local indie scene with which he toured. The buzz around his 2005 tape caught the ear of executives at Epic Records. In 2008, Hussle released two mixtapes with Epic Records, Bullets Ain't Got No Name, Volume 1 and Volume 2. In 2010, Hussle made a change from Epic Records, taking the opportunity to go independent, shifting his priorities to the audience that had already proven its loyalty. He put out mixtapes for free at a steady clip, and by 2013, he had built up a large enough following to try a unique business model for his next release. His mixtape, Crenshaw, was an ode to the predominantly black, tight-knit Crenshaw district in the southern LA area where he grew up. In addition to his successful rap recordings, Hussle opened a business in the Slauson-Crenshaw area with the intention of contributing to the vitality of the area. However, he met a sudden and violent death in 2019. We proudly celebrate this truly influential contemporary recording artist and recognize the impact he had on the community. Other shooters, we was both throwing my crew on your neck. I'm on the freeway and a drop, it got me losing my breath. I do the dash with the blues on the deck.
Yolanda West remembers Neva Lewis, great aunt. Anthony Jerome Mitchell, brother. Mr. and Mrs. James Lee Mitchell, parents. Dr. Don Lee White, friend and mentor. Dr. J. Harrison Wilson, mentor. Alva Harper, friend. Dorothy Jackson Hayes, friend. Danellen Joseph, friend. Clarence Mitchell Sr., uncle. Sandra Wheeler remembers Mr. and Mrs. Johnny and Rosella Rue, grandparents. Mr. and Mrs. John and Aliska Gordon, grandparents. Mr. and Mrs. John, Nora, and Rita Gordon, parents. Mr. and Mrs. John and Gloria Rue, uncle and aunt. Mr. and Mrs. Earl and Eula Despuis, uncle and aunt. Mr. and Mrs. Joseph and Yvonne Allain, uncle and aunt. Mr. and Mrs. Albert and Geraldine Rue, uncle and aunt. Father Joseph Anthony Rodney, cousin. Mrs. Virginia Valdry, cousin. Mr. Herbert Lombard, cousin. Mr. Ubaldo Barreda, brother-in-law. Mr. Jose Rivera, brother-in-law. Joseph Allain Jr., cousin. Joseph Holly Allain, son of cousin. Patsy Chester, friend. Joan Thomas, friend. John Carter, friend. Shardrick Boone, friend. Dr. Theodore Alexander, friend. Miss Fedra Battle, friend. Michael Dominique, friend. Celia Post, friend. Reverend Lloyd Galloway, friend. Dr. Jacqueline Broussard, friend. Albert Delpit, friend. Henry Clemens, friend. Dr. Fred Alexander, friend. Cynthia Pachot, friend. Donald LeBlanc, friend. Gertrude Bossier, friend. Lorraine Julian, friend. Elodia Sandoval, friend. Donna Watkins Wilson remembers Emmett and Mitty Watkins' parents. Joyce Wooden Norfleet remembers Danelle and Joseph Soror, Dorothy Jackson Hayes, friend.
For joining the Georgia Laster Association of Musicians Incorporated 52nd Annual Memorial Event. Your support is what keeps us going. Donations are accepted all year long. All you have to do is go to our website at www.glaminc.org and click on the Donate tab. Or you can mail us a check that's made payable to Glam, Inc. Our address is 3651 South La Brea Avenue, number 119, Los Angeles, California, 90016. We also invite you to become a member. Get involved. We need you. Our youth need you. Some of the events that we host annually to support our youth are our Spotlight on Youth concert, which this year is on December the 18th at 3 p.m. Our Black History program, which is in February. Our High School Scholarship program, our competition actually, which is going to be June 17th in 2023 at 1 p.m. We have a members concert and we have a memorial program, just like this one. So the dates of those events will be determined later next year. It takes a lot of work to make all of this happen, so we really do need you, and we ask for you to just come on and get in, roll up your sleeves and get involved. I want to say thank you to all of the people who contributed to making this event today happen. Our GLAM Program Planning Committee, you all are really the best. Our president, Yolanda West, she is a force that is driven with a purpose. Our performers, James Bryant, James Calhoun, Patty Anderson, and Jordan West, thank you. Thank you so much for the contributions you made. Also, thank you to James Goins for the music that he created for us. And to all of our readers, Melissa Cook, Yolanda West, Rosemary Cook Glover, and notably, Hansonia Caldwell. She always makes the history come alive for us. A note of gratitude to Byron Smith for producing this event and for giving us all the technical support we needed to make it happen. And to all of you for supporting and viewing, thank you, and God bless.